Hello, and thank you for joining me. I'm Kimberlei Davis. Former President Barack Obama thanked the artist for capturing his wife's hotness during the unveiling of their portraits at the Smithsonian National Portrait Gallery yesterday. Take a listen.
Amy, I want to thank you for so spectacularly capturing the grace and beauty and intelligence and charm and hotness of the woman that I love.
On last night's episode of Celebrity Big Brother, Omarosa warned America of a scary pence. And roses are red, violets are blue. How much are you planning to spend for the one you love so true? Those trending headlines, celebrity birthdays, and your moment in history. That's all coming up next, today, Tuesday, February 13th.
Amy, I want to thank you for so spectacularly capturing the grace and beauty and intelligence and charm and hotness of the woman that I love.
Barack and Michelle Obama were the talk of social media Monday, but it had nothing to do with politics. Official portraits of the former first couple were unveiled at the Smithsonian's National Portrait Gallery. As Jeannie Moles reports, the portraits had some raising their own eyebrows.
There they were in the flesh, holding hands, waiting for their National Gallery portraits to be unveiled. First hers. And then his. Not your average National Gallery presidential portrait.
That's pretty sharp.
But what's with all the greenery? In the weeds, as usual, I see, tweeted one critic. Coming out of Wrigley's left field, commented someone else. Both President Obama and the former First Lady chose African-American artists. Kahinde Wiley explained the plants include flowers from Chicago, Hawaii, and Kenya, but all some could see was Sean Spicer hiding in the bushes. Someone else noticed a similarity to Beyoncé's pregnancy announcement. The artist Wiley is known for painting African Americans like Michael Jackson in royal settings, mimicking old masters. He choked up, thanking his mom.
We didn't have much, but she found a way to get paint.
Amy Sherrill painted Michelle's portrait using gray tones to downplay skin color so her subject's personality would come to the fore. President Obama thanked her for capturing the intelligence
and hotness of the woman that I love.
The First Lady reacted to her own image.
Let's just start by saying wow.
But who instead of wow is what half of the people we asked said.
She's an actress? I have no idea.
A little like Michelle Obama.
A little like her, but I don't think it is her.
No.
Who is this woman?
That is a very good question.
That's a gorgeous picture of Michelle Obama.
I have no idea.
Some who recognize Michelle Obama.
God only knows. Michelle Obama.
Did it the roundabout way.
I know those arms.
Great guns, as they say.
And you know what they say about Obama's portrait. He has very big hands. Jeannie Mo, CNN, New York.
Former White House aide turned Celebrity Big Brother contestant Omarosa Manigault Newman described Vice President Mike Pence as, quote, extreme and scary. CNN's Allison Camerota and Chris Cuomo pick up the story.
Former White House aide turned Celebrity Big Brother contestant Omarosa issuing a warning to people who want President Trump impeached.
Can I just say this? As bad as y'all think Trump is, you would be worried about Pence.
I know.
So everybody that's wishing for impeachment
might want to
reconsider their lives.
Absolutely.
We would be begging for days of Trump back if Pence became president. That's all I'm saying. He's extreme. I'm Christian. I love Jesus. But he thinks Jesus tells him to say things there. I'm like, Jesus ain't say that.
Is this all that Celebrity Big Brother has become? People tune into these shows for a diversion, not for more talk of politics.
The poor people sitting on the couch Yeah, they're trapped.
I hurt my back. I thought it was like that. I hurt this disc in my back, but I think from constant shaking of my head, I have hurt my spinal cord.
Yeah, that might be permanent.
And Omarosa, she's going to be in the lawsuit when I eventually have to find out who did this to me.
Love is in the air. The National Retail Federation says Americans will spend a total of $19.6 billion this Valentine's Day. That's a lot of flowers and chocolate. And it's more money than last year. Mary Maloney breaks down the Valentine's spending in today's Consumer Watch.
Cupid's arrow may puncture your wallet. The National Retail Federation says people plan to spend about $145 on Valentine's gifts. That's about $7 more than last year. Sweethearts will get the bulk of the presents. Those celebrating Valentine's Day plan to spend about $90 on their significant others. Kids and parents will also feel the love, getting roughly $25 worth of stuff. Most plan to allocate around $7 for teachers and friends. And man's best friend will get a little something to the tune of about $6. Retailers must love Valentine's Day. Average jewelry sales could hit $4.7 billion. $2 billion is expected to go for flowers, $1.8 billion on candy, and $894 million could be spent on those lovey-dovey cards. No matter if you get your Valentine a card, chocolate, or a fancy dinner out, this celebration is going to be sweet. For Consumer Watch, I'm Mary Maloney.
In 1997, the king of pop, Michael Jackson, and then-wife Debbie Rowe became parents to a son named Prince. Happy birthday if you're celebrating today. You share the day with former NFL player Randy Moss. He's 41. MC Natalie Stewart of Floetry is 39. And talk show host Jerry Springer is 74. Well, that's our time for today. You've been watching What's Trending. Get more headlines on our ABC Columbia mobile app and at abccolumbia.com. I'm Kimberlei Davis. Be kind to each other. I hope that you're Have a great Tuesday, and thanks for watching.
Tonight, we're dishing romance, movies, and love. Now, how are you going to say no to that?
What don't you know about your favorite romantic movies? What happened behind the scenes you'd never imagine? From Titanic to The Notebook, 27 Dresses to 50 Shades.
I know what you did.
Now, on the night before Valentine's, we're dishing big time with the stars themselves.
This is very romantic.
You're going to love this. Lights, camera, romance.
Hosted by Katherine Heigl. Tonight at 10, 9 Central on ABC.